Hello, flowers of kefir blossoms. Just want to show you the size of a kefir grain that's grown in my jar. That's one mother of a grain. Isn't it? It's a flat sheathed grain. See all those growths on there? They all become individual grains when they drop off, and they turn into well, there's another nice long one. They turn into there's another big one. They turn into grains like that once they drop off the mothership. Now that's a massive grain. Massive. That's going to go in my jar. I don't usually pick grains up by hand. I'm just doing this just because to show you how kefir grains can grow into monsters under the right conditions. Those grains that grow flat like this, they were originally what I call self-enclosed grains, bodies like these. Now, they are a grain that's got a center piece or a midsection which is closed, like a balloon that's closed. And in that balloon, there's kefir, inside that grain, there's kefiran. Now, if I was to pop one of these grains open, right, what happens is milk gets into that enclosed grain and the grain starts growing flat outwardly into that, and as big as those grains I just showed you. This is another example of the same thing happening. It was originally one enclosed grain, but it was popped open and now it's growing flat. But eventually they start growing these lobules all over the surface, as you can see. And they detach and become enclosed grains, which is the natural structure of kefir grains under optimum conditions. And that means where they don't get forced physically to be popped open. See, these are all closed grains. That's the tendency they want to grow. Well, they have a tendency to want to grow in that fashion, self-enclosed bodies. Okay. Signing off.